Hey Sandra. Can you believe Mr. Smith wants us to have 10 internet resources in our final paper?
Hi Derek. No, I can't. How does he expect us to find 10 good resources online? Whenever I put something into Google, I get millions of results, and it all looks like junk to me.
I know what you mean. I know what I'm going to be doing with my weekends for the next 5 weeks. Goodbye, social life. It's going to take forever to wade through all of those sites to find the few good ones. I'll catch you later.
I wish there was a way to wave a magic wand and make the good results pop up to the top. Then I wouldn't have to spend so much of my time searching.
You called?
Who are you?
I'm the sorceress of sources to the rescue. Answering the call of stressed out students and frazzled faculty anywhere, anytime.
So, if you're a superhero, where is your costume?
What do you mean? I'm wearing it. This is pretty snazzy for a librarian. I'm not even wearing a cardigan. Did you notice the British accent?
Okay. So, sorceress of sources, how can you possibly help me with internet searching?
I'm so glad you asked. Searching the internet can be a snap if you know some of the tricks of the trade that we librarians use. Whether it is using the Google toolbar or domain searching, these tips will save you time and have you surfing like a pro. Let me turn this over to my colleague Andrea to show us some pointers on search engines.
Thanks, Sorceress. So let's start off with a basic definition of search engines so that we're all on the same page. A search engine is a program that searches for information from a set group of sources. In our case, we're going to look at internet search engines. So web pages are the information, and the entire internet is the source. The searcher enters keywords into the search engine, and then the program applies certain methods to scan the internet content and bring back web page results. Although everyone's familiar with Google, there are many different types of search engines out there, and some are worth mentioning, because each one searches the World Wide Web in a little different way. One popular alternative is Bing at www.bing.com. Another alternative is using a site like dogpile.com, which is really a meta search engine. When you search dogpile.com for something, let's say pumpkin pie recipes, it will actually go out and search Google, Yahoo, and Bing, three popular search engines, and compile the results for you. The results are separated into paid ads at the top and bottom, and then your search results are actually sandwiched in between those. You can see where each result came from. This one was found on Google, Yahoo, and Bing. And you can see this one says it was found exclusively on Google. So what a nice way to save some time, right? Getting all your results compiled in one place. We may as well go ahead and talk about those paid ads now and get it out of the way, because we are going to be seeing them pop up again and again. They aren't necessarily evil, but they aren't exactly harmless either. Search engines have to make money to survive, right? So they support themselves through paid advertisements. Even though these results are presented first, it doesn't mean they are the most relevant to your search. Now, if you're searching for pumpkin pie recipes, that might not be such a big deal. But if you're searching for medical advice or seeking an unbiased article on a topic, then it gets a little more complicated. So all of this is to say, make sure you're very aware of where the ads are displayed on the page and think twice before deeming it appropriate content. Moving on, now we all know that most web research starts at Google, so that's where we're heading. Let's start at the opening screen. Let's say I'm a student doing research on kidney disease. Chances are many of you would probably get to this screen and just type in kidney disease and hit search. Now you can see that there are over 20 million results for kidney disease. Here are those paid ads I was talking about, shaded in slightly yellow along the top and along the side in Google. And then your actual search results are found here in the middle. Just looking at the results can tell you a lot about whether or not the site is worth visiting. First, you have the title of the web page. National Kidney Foundation, kidney disease. And under that is a URL or a web address, www.kidney.org/kidney disease. If that web address contains a .edu, .org, or .gov instead of a .com, .biz, or .info, then chances are that that site contains more quality information that can be trusted and is from a school of education, nonprofit organization, or government organization. Usually the first few lines from the description are shown also. And if you hover just to the right of the description, you can see a snapshot of the actual website to decide if you actually want to visit that page or not. 20 million results is an awful lot to sift through, so you might want to consider using some of the tricks of the trade to narrow your search. Remember how I said that government publications, .gov, are really great resources? Sometimes they can be a great place to do medical research. You can search just government websites by using the advanced search feature in Google. Now, Google makes you really work for this. You have to really want to find it on their page. They put the advanced search button all the way down here at the bottom underneath your results. Just click that, and then you'll see the different options that you have. Let's see, we should probably change this up a bit to be more to our liking. We want the exact phrase, kidney disease. So let's put that in exact phrase. And then all the way down at the bottom, we want to search within the site or domain. We want .gov in the URL. So this will just search any site that contains .gov within their URL or web address. You could use this to search any particular site, such as ESPN.com or YouTube.com. Notice that you can also use a little plus sign here to add date ranges to your search. Let's say we only want pages created within the past year. Okay, and then you have to hit the advanced search button. Now we're getting a little over 100,000 results. It's a lot better than 20 million by far. Still a lot, but I think we have more quality results. Now I want you to notice the search bar. This is how an advanced search looks. You don't always have to go to advanced search to enter this. You can type in advanced searches yourself if you know the shortcuts. For example, anytime you want to do a search for an exact phrase, you simply type in the phrase in quotation marks. If you want to search for the song title, Love Me Tender, you would type in the phrase, Love Me Tender, in quotation marks. That just tells the search engine to look for those words together in that exact order. Similarly, if you want to do a site search, you would type in the word site, followed by a colon, no space, and then the name of the site or domain name. If you wanted to search for the name Tiger Woods on the site ESPN.com, you would enter the search like this. Now, this is still searching within the past year. We could do any time. And now it's giving us Tiger Woods, ESPN.com site. All of these are from ESPN.com and contain the name Tiger Woods. Another really great shortcut is the synonym shortcut. If you type in the tilde sign, that's the little squiggly line just to the left of the number one on your keyboard, before a word, Google will bring back the results for that word and others like it. So if you search for tilde sign kidney disease, you can see that the results are now about 34 million and include the terms bladder, liver, and renal disease. Why would you want to include more results? This is a great tool to use when your search is not turning up enough results or the right types of results and you need to expand your keyword. Okay, so now let me show you one last thing on Google, and this just might impress your socks off, mostly because many of you are going to be shocked you've never noticed it before. Over on the left-hand side of the screen is the Google toolbar. This thing rocks. Here's where you can limit your search to different formats. For instance, many people know about the Google image search, but if you click on videos, you now have about 15,000 videos about kidney disease to choose from. And now the other options have changed as well. and we could choose our video source down here at the bottom. And we could limit it to videomd.com instead of YouTube videos and probably get more quality videos than we would have found on YouTube about kidney disease and still have 55 to choose from. If you click on the More button, it gives you more options of formats to choose from, such as Google Books, blogs, and discussions. There is a time designation on the toolbar as well, so you can search for events that have happened in the past hour, past week, past month, or you can even choose a custom range. Finally, the last thing I want to talk to you about is knowing how to put together a good search phrase. You can know all the fancy tips and tricks and tools the internet has to offer, but unless you can put together keywords in a meaningful manner, you aren't going to be living up to your search potential. So here are a few words to the wise on the subject. Use keywords, not full sentences, and combine them with Boolean operators. Yes, that is English. Boolean operators are the words and or not that you can use to combine keyword phrases to make your searches more specific. Using the and term brings back searches that have all of the words in every result. Using or will bring back results that have any of the words in the results. For example, if I search for children and poetry, every site Google brings back will have the words children and poetry in them. However, if I do a search for children or poetry, that means that every site that Google brings back will have one or the other found on the page, which means that there'll be more potential results. Now, not you can use if you want to exclude a word from your search results. For instance, poetry, not children. In Google, you have to use the minus sign without a space before a word to indicate the not operator. So if I wanted to do a search for disease but did not want to include results for kidney disease, I would search for disease and then use the minus sign with no space and then type the word kidney and then hit search. This would exclude all results for kidney disease and leave me with lists of other disease in my results. What do I mean by all of this? Sure, Google's probably smart enough to come back with some type of meaningful results to what are the symptoms, stages, treatment options for kidney disease. However, a much more precise search would boil this down to the main words, which would be symptoms, stages, treatment, and kidney disease. We could combine these into keyword searches that would look something like this. Symptoms and stages and treatment and kidney disease. Now, the results we get back from this, I guess about treatment correctly. The results we get back from this should be much more focused results. And we could look at the results list that we get. Here we have kidney disease, symptoms, treatment of. These results seem to be much more focused. And what we could do is look at the list and then use our advanced searching down at the bottom and the tools on the left to narrow these results down even further. Thanks for watching this video. I wish I could tell you even more, but I don't want to give away all of my secrets. But stay tuned for more tutorials in the Secrets Revealed series. Until then, happy searching.